Oh, sweet Jesus. So, so here's what happened today. Well, I got fucked. That's basically what happened. So last night I went to pay my internet bill, and it runs around $64. Well, I went to the website. It's chugging along. I don't know if it's his tablet or whatever. My internet's been kind of running slow as far as like websites go. I don't know. Is it freaking net neutrality? I don't know. Or is it just this old shitty tablet? I don't know. Anyways, it's chugging along. Finally, it goes through. Okay, fine. Now, keep in mind, I moved the Wi-Fi into the room. Because it used to be outside the door. Well, whatever. So, okay, fine. But it's right here. It's within 15, 20 feet. I mean, it's like I could spit and it's right there. So, there shouldn't be a problem. But the site was chugging. It was chugging. Like I said, finally it went through. So, I put in all my information. I log in. And when I go to hit okay, like, you know, pay the bill, it says, sorry, but your card has been declined. Okay. I try it again. Sorry, your card has been declined. So, I close it down, open it back up, do it again. Whatever. So, like the third or fourth time, apparently it's got to be the fourth time, I did it. It went right through without a problem. So, I'm not thinking anything of it. I go to the store today. You know, I know how much money's in there, roughly. I go to take out money for my rent. And it says it's been declined. There's not enough funds. And I'm like, what? What? How is there not enough fuck funds? So, needless to say, because I owe Dale T some money, because I had a... Dude, I had a mix-up back in January, and I've been paying him like 20 bucks a month, because... whatever, I wasn't able to pay him. And I was only able to take out a certain amount, which was $20 short from what my rent is. So my rent is $20 short. So I basically come home. I put my freezer stuff away quick. I didn't even bring in the rest of the groceries. They're still outside. It's warm as fuck out there. So, you know, whatever. But I put in all the freezer stuff. And, of course, I had Burger King, so that was sitting here. It got cold. Yeah, seriously, there's nothing worse than those cold Burger King french fries. Oh, God. Ugh. And that doesn't even include the woman who was at Burger King who was new and completely fucked everything up. I wanted to try the new spicy nuggets. And I said, you know, give me a 20-piece. Usually I get a 10, but I wanted to try them in case they were good. Somehow she ended up giving me a 10-piece regular and then a 20-piece spicy. So I had like 30 nuggets. And I'm like, whatever, man. And this is after she rang me up on the wrong register. Which, don't even get me started. But, whatever. So I get home, I got my food, I put my freezer stuff away. I come in, I get online, I check my account, and I look, and it's $64, $64, $64, $64. And I'm like, what? Because that's my internet from Spectrum. And I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? First off, it said the card was declined, which is bullshit. Okay, first off, the card shouldn't have been declined. And if the card was declined, then it shouldn't have gone through anyway. But apparently it did. So... now, I am not going to get on the phone. I don't give a fuck. I don't do the phone. I don't like the phone. Luckily, they had, do you want to talk to a person? And you can do it right there. You can chat. You can live chat. And I'm like, okay, yeah, let me live chat. And somebody was there. Somebody, Kimberly, I think her name was. Kim C, I think her name was. Or whatever the fuck her name is. Her last name started with a C. Whatever. So, she asked me, you know, every time I sign into their fucking network, this is back when they were Time Warner, there's a problem. I don't know what it is. Because, well, I used to have phone with them, and I got rid of it and ended up getting the basic talk, which is like $12 a month. I was paying Time Warner $40 a month for basically Dale T to call up and say, hello? That was basically the extent of it. I was paying $40, and I was like, fuck that. So, I've been to Time Warner in person multiple times, and I gave them my telephone number, my new telephone number, and they punched it in, but every time they ask for my phone number, it's not in their system. So, we're having a problem getting in. She then asked me, what's the last four digits of your social security? That's like asking me what the nuclear codes are. I don't remember what my fucking social security card is. Nobody asked me social security. I haven't been asked social security in probably 20 years. Okay. And I'm thinking, oh, Jesus. I start rattling off, blah, 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 dash, blah, 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 dash, blah, 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 blah. I am giving her the wrong, and I said, I was like, oh, God, I don't even remember. And I type it in. I typed in, oh, God, I don't even remember. I think it's blah, 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 blah. And I gave her, like, the first, I gave her, like, the whole thing, basically. I gave her, like, the first, because it's 3 digits, dash, 2 digits, dash, 4 digits. And I couldn't remember. Well, I kept saying it over and over and over. Halfway through the conversation, I was like, oh, this is what it is, blah. And she said, yes, that's what it is, because, you know, it was on the information, but I was giving her the wrong thing, yet she was trying to help me get into the site, and, of course, I don't remember my freaking Social Security. So then she has me after the Social Security didn't work, she said, well, can you go get your bill? And I had just gotten a bill. I was all excited. I was like, yes, I know where it is. So I actually got up. I'm laying in the bed with the tablet. I got up and went and got the thing. I'm like, here it is. I open it up. It's a fucking advertisement. So then she gives me the novel idea. Well, can you open it up? And I told her I was on a tablet, you know, whatever. And she said, well, can you open up the site again and get the PDF of your last bill? So when I went in there, and then it says account number, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, oh, great. So I highlight the account number. I go to the other page, the other web page, and I call up the account. And when I do, I can't bring up the frickin' box to type again. I don't know what was going on. Finally, after a bunch of bullshit and finagling, I get it in there. I hold it down, and I'm ready to, like, cut and paste. It won't let me cut and paste. And I'm like, God damn. So then I have to go back. And, of course, now I'm flustered. So I do whatever the numbers were. I do the first four. I memorize those. And then I go back to the other page, type them in, go back to the other, the next four, blah, blah, blah. Finally, I give her my account number, and she's like, ah, there you are, blah, blah, blah. You know, she said that only one of them went through, and there was another one pending. I said, well, I'd like you to cancel the pending, obviously, because I only want to pay once. And that was basically the extent of that. Thank you, goodbye, have a good day, blah, blah, blah. Now, I have to wait for my bank account to realize what's going on. Because it's showing that they basically took out the money, even though they didn't actually take out the money. Which, I don't... And, of course, I can't email my cousin, the landlord, to explain why rent is $20 short. Luckily, I had even that much in there. So I had to go on to Messenger, because what happened was my email had gotten hacked a few years ago. Actually, it got hacked with part of the PSN hack back in 2011. The Yahoo account, that fucker's been hacked. And, which I think Yahoo itself started to shit the bed, because it was having problems. I can't get in there. The password, something's with the password. And if I go to reestablish a new password, it just, it gives me a song and dance, and it's just, I can't get in. And I don't even use it anyway, so I don't give a fuck anymore. So that's why I couldn't email my cousin, you know, the landlord, basically. So I had to then go on Messenger. One of my cousin, Cindy, who is my landlord's sister, has a friend named Patty, and I had to go on Instant Messenger to Patty and say, can I please get a message to Cindy that I need to tell Mary that something happened and I was overcharged and I don't have money in my account and I'm $20 short. Could you please tell Cindy to tell Mary to... And she's like, yeah, no problem, blah, 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 don't worry. It's just, oh my God. Because as far as like phone and stuff, first of all, I don't use the phone. I don't do the phone. I got a thing with the phone. I got a phobia with the phone. I don't use the phone. I just don't use the phone. I will not use the phone. And because cousin Sandy doesn't have, she doesn't do electronic shit. She doesn't like email and stuff like that. Like her friends will show her shit on the phone. They'll show her like, you know, stupid videos or whatnot, or they'll relay information. Like there was one time, one of her friends, what was it? One of her friends is what do you call that shit? Not lactose intolerant. What's that? Glucose or whatever the fuck it is. Gluten free. That's what it is. And I jokingly posted on Facebook that there was this this video of somebody cooking, and they've got an empty pot, and they're slowly stirring basically air, and then they carefully scoop it out, and again, it's just air. There's nothing in the pot, and it's like, and it said something to the effect of, you know, gluten-free cooking, and it basically was cooking air, so there was like nothing there. So I posted that and made a little joke, and basically, it got around to Cousin Cindy through the friend with the phone, and it just, you gotta understand. So the other cousin, who is the landlord, I don't have her information, because like I said, I can't get through to her on email, and she doesn't do Messenger. So I had to go through a person to get to a person to get to a person to get to a person to get this to happen. And because what happens is if the bank registers it as this is $64 coming out, which it shouldn't, because the woman said that after a few days it'll realize it's not, it was multiple incursions to the site, and it'll put the money back in. It'll say the money's there. But that's one thing I do like about the debit card. If the money's not there, it was like, no, you can't have this money, asshole. Which I don't particularly like, but I like the fact that... Because if when I came home, I had like $8 left in the account. If I had taken out the money that I wanted to take out, that I needed to take out... Because I took out like $20 more than what I was supposed to. I wanted to actually take out like $60. So I would have been like... $38 in the hole, and that's not including the other stuff that's supposed to come out. Now luckily I think there's only two things that are supposed to come out, and they're like $20, but if they come out right now, I'm gonna overdraft, and so I may need to actually have a ride, and I explain that to Patty, to tell Cousin Cindy. I may need a ride to the bank, which isn't that far, it's like literally down the road. It's just constant stupid shit. Again, if the thing said it's declined, well, it should have declined. Yet their stupid website just went through and like, oh yeah, cha-ching, cha-ching. And a woman said that it didn't charge, even though the bank is saying that it did. So it might just work itself out, and I'm praying to Christ that it does, and I mean that legitimately. I'm literally praying to God that it does. Because I don't feel like fucking with this. But I've got two things that need to come out. I got two $10 things that are going to come out automatically. And I don't have $10 in there. I don't have $20 in there. I got $8 something. So I'm going to be like probably $12 short from what I need. That means it's a $12 overdraft fee. And keep in mind, if you don't pay the overdraft fee, they charge you more, and they charge you more, and they charge you more. And this is the second. So I've got the entire month to go, and if there's not money in that motherfucker, oops. Okay, oops. You know? So hopefully, like I said, it'll just work itself out. I don't know, man. Anyways, that's what I've had to deal with today. Because, well, I went shopping today, and I told Dilty I need to go to the dollar store because I need to pick up cleaning supplies, and I didn't get all the cleaning supplies I wanted because I wanted to get some Febreze, and I didn't, and luckily I didn't because I wouldn't have had fucking money. And, well, what happened was, well, I don't want to get into that, but I ended up spending like $54 there. I then went to pay my electric, and that was $54. But I didn't know how much money I had, so I said, let's just do 40. So I owe like 12 bucks to that, but big deal. I picked that up next month. And then when I went to freaking Walmart, I had to pay whatever. I had to pay like $17 or something for whatever. And that was a whatever. That was a problematic experience in and of itself. So anyways, I get home, and it was something I was going to say, and I forgot what it was, so I'm kind of rambling right now, and I apologize, because I'm trying to remember what the hell it is I was going to say, because I had a point for telling all that. What was the purpose? I don't even remember. Anyways, who gives a fuck? So, yeah, I mean, whatever, man. I don't know. I don't know why things have to happen to me. It said it was declined. I don't understand why. But, again, the woman assured me that it only took out one and that they canceled the second one. So if they canceled the second one, hopefully the bank will realize, okay, this was done in mistake. I don't want to give them $400 fucking dollars. No, it wasn't that much. It was like 100 and... Oh, it was 64 times 4. I don't know. That's at least 200. So I got 64, 64, and 64. Which is like, what, 180, 90, something like that? I think $190. $190. Because I had to take out... I was supposed to take out money. I was supposed to give Dale T $20. I was supposed to take out another $20 for when I go to Burger King in 2 weeks. I wanted to have a $20 bill on me. And I was supposed to have $20 to take out for my gas tank for Cousin Cindy because she said she would fill the tank for me. I was supposed to have $20 there. And I didn't. So, I don't know, man. I don't know what to say. I really don't. So, I mean, it's always a freaking problem, dude. I don't leave the fucking house. Yeah, it's a problem every single solitary time I do anything. And then I go downstairs the other night. Well, actually, what happened, this is just kind of a two-part story. So, 2 weeks ago, well, last month, I had a problem. And the problem was that my back went out. But before that, my problem was I had to go to town. I had to go to Rome. Because they are the only place that have a barber. I think there's one in town, but I don't know. But I know where this one is. I wanted to go to Walmart. It was an excuse to go to Rome, basically. Well, I go to Rome, and I pick up some hamburger patties, and I get a haircut. And I was too tired after the haircut because my back was all fucked up, and my legs and whatnot, and my hip and whatnot. I just couldn't do it. So I pick up the hamburg patty. Well, actually, Dale T picked up the hamburg patties and left them there in a cart. And then I come out and I cashed out. And that's after trying to walk halfway to the back of the fucking store to get the electronics. There was stuff I wanted to do, but this didn't happen. But whatever, that's a whole other story. And I told it in one of the other clips. So anyways, I get back and I'm just too tired to do anything. So I ended up getting some lunch meat and that was it. I don't know how I made it until the 17th of that month. Because again, I go early in the month, like third or fourth of the month, depending on what day it is and depending what day DLT is available. I go from like the second, third, somewhere in there. And then I go on the 15th, 17th, somewhere in there. I go twice a month. And I don't know how I made it from the beginning of the month to the middle of the month. Because all I bought was lunch meat. Because, like I said, I was just too tired to do anything. So, which is kind of what happened today. Oh, that's what it was I wanted to talk about. Because today, when I went, we were going to go to town, like I said. But I told DLT, I want to go to the dollar store first because I need cleaning supplies. And the reason I wanted to do those is because the cleaning supplies are in the back. And I only have so much limited physical energy that I can exert. And then after that, my back tightens up, my leg goes out, and, you know, there comes a point where I may not be able to put weight on my leg. Or my back can support me, so I will maybe fall. Okay, now, if I went to town, which is like 45 minutes away, putzed around there, came back, went to the other store, which I was supposed to, and then go to the dollar store, there's no way I'd be getting in the back to get the cleaning supplies, and I needed the cleaning supplies. So I told DLT, instead of going to the store automatically, going to town automatically, and when I say town, I mean like the Lowville, which is like 45 minutes away, and Rome is 45 minutes the other way. We were going to Lowville today. So I basically told him I need to go to the dollar store because I need to go there first because I need to get that shit ASAP. While I've got the energy, I need to be able to get in the back to get that stuff. So he didn't quite get that, but we ended up going. And then after that, and I barely was making it. I got what I needed. I got into the back. I got all the stuff. With the exception of a couple things. No big deal, though. I don't really need those things, but it would have been nice to get. But anyway, good thing I didn't. But anyway, whatever. Oh, shoot, and I forgot. I want to get disinfectant wipes. Oh, well. What was I saying? So anyways, I got what I needed. But it took a lot out of me. And going directly from there, literally across the street to pay the electric, my back is all fucked up. So as I was coming out of paying the electric, there's this little curb, and I stepped down, and when I did, something pulled in my right hip. My thigh region. No, it was upper hip. It was like lower back, upper hip. And I'm like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Because it was painful. Like, I couldn't even get in the truck. It was so painful. And I'm like, god damn. Because the whole day is revolving around this trip. Okay? And it's kind of the same thing that happened last month. So I had to have cousins. That's right. I was setting up for the story here. I'm all over the place. And I apologize. But needless to say, I was in a lot of pain. So I was hoping that our trip to and from here into, you know, the big town, that my back would rest up and heal up. It kind of sort of did to a point, although it still took a lot out of me. But last month, when we went to Rome to get the haircut, not so much. Now, what happened was when I got back to town, I was completely fucked up. So I didn't get a lot of food. So I had to have Cousin Cindy take my card and go shopping for me. Because I did go in the middle of the month, but something happened then, too, where it was just I didn't buy anything. Because, again, my back was all screwed up. My back has been screwed up for most of this year, my back's been fucked up. So, needless to say, I had to have her go shopping for me. And when she did, she took my debit card, she took my card, and then when she came back, she handed it to me, I was like, oh, okay, cool. Because what she did is she brought all the groceries up, and she left them there by my door. When she ended up ringing the doorbell, calling me out, and when she handed it to me directly, I put it in one of the bags. And I kind of forgot about it. Now, 2-3 days go by, and I'm like, where's my card? And it's like, holy shit, because without that, I'm fucked. I mean, in general, I'm fucked. I mean, I could get a new one, but to go through that, it's a pain in the dick. And they got it, because they'd have to cancel the one. And it's like, I didn't want them to do any of that, because I know the number by heart, and I don't want to have them issue me a new card with a new number. I know the card number. So, like, when I type it in, when I order pizza and stuff, it's like, and it's like, I know what it is. I can do it automatically without thinking about it. And trying to relearn a new number, no. So I'm going through stuff. Because the store that she went to, they have yellow plastic bags. So I'm looking at all the yellow plastic bags. I'm looking. I pull out stuff from my garbage, and I'm thinking, oh, shit, because I threw out a bunch of stuff the other day. Or when this happened, the other day. And I'm like, did I accidentally throw it in the trash, bundle up the trash, and take it out? Now, what happens is I usually take the garbage and I leave it outside the door, and Cousin Cindy sometimes comes by and finds it and takes it down for me. Or she doesn't. The next time I go down, because I don't go downstairs that much other than like the two times, or unless I'm ordering pizza. So, you know, the few times that I order pizza, which it's only like once or twice a month, if that, I'll take a bag down. Sometimes I got two or three bags sitting there. I'll take one down. Because I could put them in my bucket, but I don't want them to leak, because my bucket's for groceries, and I don't want stinky garbage in there, you know? Whatever. So anyway, sometimes she takes it down, and I'm like, oh shit, did I bundle up? Did I just take this yellow bag and be like, oh, fucking threw it in the trash? I threw a bunch of bags out the other day, because I had a bunch of them when I went shopping earlier. So I ended up going all the way downstairs. I go look through all the buckets, the trash buckets, downstairs, and I realize that the garbage man had just come. Now, they usually come on Monday. And I'm like, no, it couldn't be, because she went on Tuesday. Unless for some reason they were late or they changed their schedule that I didn't realize. Because if the card had gotten thrown out into a trash bag and she had taken it down like that day, and they came, you know, it could be in a landfill somewhere, and it would not be cool. So anyways, I'm searching high and low. I'm looking. Now, at this time, I had put together some water in a pot, and I'm going to make spaghetti noodles. Now, I had her pick me up two things of spaghetti noodles. And I pulled them out, and I set them on the counter. And when I went to grab the thing, I looked, and my card, thank thou Christ, literally got wedged between the two packages of spaghetti noodles. So when I pulled it out, because I grabbed them by the middle, I pulled them out together. It took the card with it, and the card was just sitting there. But holy crap, dude, going through that, it was panicking, because it's like, what do I do? Because if I do that, if I lose it, or I lost it, or I did something, or I damage it, then I gotta fuck around. I gotta actually go to the bank, which means I gotta get a ride, which means somebody's gonna have to come and take me there, which is a bunch of bullshit, and it's just not good. It's just not good. So, for about, well, however long it took me to finish dinner, at least a good 20 to 30 minutes, I kept, like, reassuring myself, okay, I got the card, yes, I got the card, there it is, I see it, because it was just, I had worked myself up, and it was like, what the fuck, you know, because, I mean, that's legitimately scary shit, especially when you have, like, no other income of any kind, and if that card is not available, you know, you're fucked, you're literally bent over the barrel, and there's no, it's not like you got somebody else who can say, oh, yeah, here's $20, you can get some food for the rest of the week. You know, or here's, you know, $40, you can get food for the rest of the week and pay me back later. No. There's nobody like that. So if I lose my card, I lose everything. I'm fucked. It's not cool. So, anyways, needless to say, That's what I had been dealing with. And it was all based upon my freaking back going out. And like I said, that happened last month, and then it happens again this month when, I mean, I really hadn't even left town in my back. I tweaked something in my lower back. And, but luckily I was able to make the rounds at Walmart. I sent DLT off for butter, but I was able to get most of the other stuff. It's getting harder and harder for me to shop. But I will say, last night I had ordered subs last night. And those fucking things made my freaking mouth dry as dicks. Holy fuck. So, I didn't want to drink a lot of liquid. But I had to. I drank like four cups, because I had a measuring cup sitting there, and I measured out a cup, drank it, measured out another cup, drank it. I did it like four times. And this is right before I'm supposed to go to the big city, which is like, again, 45 minutes away. And I usually don't drink beforehand, because it's like, I don't want to have to pee. Because when your back is out, it's not easy to pee. Let's just put it that way. When you're crippled, it's not easy. Okay? Like, I may even have to sit down to pee. That's how pathetic my life is, okay? And you don't want to be sitting on no public toilet, because most of the time there's piss all over it. It's not good. The whole thing is not good. But I'm sitting there like, I need a freaking drink of freaking water. Or I need some... I had Kool-Aid at the time, and I'm like, God damn it, I need Kool-Aid. Anyways, my lips are like smacking together. Like, my lips are dry right now. My lips are chaffed right now. And they're stinging me. Okay, but when I was at Walmart, it was like, I need to get something to drink. Now, they usually have little coolers and things where there's stuff. I went to one. I could have got a crushed orange soda, which I probably should have done. But I didn't want soda. I wanted like a juice or a bottle of water. I wanted something like clean and healthy. Well, they didn't have anything within range. At least nothing that was chilled and cool. As I was looking through the fruit area, they have this thing, this little display, these chilled liquids. And I'm like, okay, that looks decent. I didn't even read it. I was like, okay, fine, whatever. It's got like berries in it. I'm thinking it's like an infused water kind of a thing. Oh my God, I get it. And I go over to where the bench is and I sit down and I start to like take a drink. It's some sort of, I don't even think it was seltzer water. It's some sort of distilled, it tasted like alcohol. Like fermented fruit alcohol, like that kind of like prison brew type shit. And I don't like that taste. I don't like a coffee taste. I don't like beer. I don't like that kind of stuff. And it was not thirst quenching. Let's just put it that way. It was not thirst quenching at all. I would have been better off with the fucking soda. So I'm sitting there, I take a sip, and I'm making faces. Like, I'm sitting there, you got a picture. Fat guy sitting on a freaking blue bench in Walmart with, like, a whole bunch of shit in his cart. He's making pucker faces because, you know, he's drinking this swill of shit, and it's just gross. So I take another sip, and I take another sip, and I take another sip, and another sip, and another sip, and another sip, and I'm like, this isn't getting any better, because I was hoping it was just like a distilled, I would have been nice with like a fruit juice even, or something. I needed something like electrolyte-y, you know, Powerade-y, something, because like everything's all, my whole body's imbalanced as it is, so, you know, I need like a Gatorade, or just something, or a Snapple. They had Snapple, but it was just sitting there, it wasn't chilled. And my throat is so dry, I need something cold. I need, like, ice and just... fuck you, you know? So, like I said, that didn't help. Now, every time we go there, Dale T has to... He'll drive me to the freaking door. And then he takes off. Because of the place, like, I guess right down the road where he buys his cheese. So he bought, like, $50 worth of cheese. Or $100, or whatever the fuck it is he bought. He bought a lot of cheese. I don't know what it was. So, he takes off. Now, which is fine, because I'm going to be sitting there. because I do the rounds, I go through, I get the, they have that General Chow chicken, because the only time I can do Chinese is when I go there. I get the General Chow chicken. That shit cost me $10 for like a little package of it, but totally worth it. And they had this bucket of chicken. I picked that up. It was going to be cold, but whatever. And they had chicken tenders. I bought a fucking pound of those. It was like, I paid like $30 in chicken, but whatever. It was totally worth it. So I made the rounds there. I went over to the cookies. I got me some cookies. I got two big trays of chocolate chip cookies and two small trays of like oatmeal raisin cookies or something. I don't know what it is. They look good though. I like me a good oatmeal cookie with raisin. I don't know what it is, but it's something about that. I don't know if I'm getting old or what, but whatever. Anyways, as I get that, I go and look at the fruit, and they got these big containers of strawberries and these big containers of blackberries, because I like to take the blackberry, blueberry, strawberry, and I like to put it into my water to infuse it. Now, infused water, not really that good. I like it better than regular water, but it's not as good. So what I like to do is sometimes I'll make a tea, an iced tea, just a regular straight sweet iced tea, and I'll do half infused, and then I'll put the tea in it, and that's really good. Or sometimes I'll put the orange juice in, that's good too. So it's like half and half. So it's like, it's kind of like watered down orange juice, watered down tea, but it's got like just enough where it's like, it's not water, but it's still healthy. There's a tiny bit of sugar in there. There's some fruit. It's good. It, believe me, at this point in my life, that's about as good as I'm going to get. So anyways, each one is like $5 a piece. $5 worth of strawberries, $5 worth of blueberries. And I'm like, okay, fine, whatever. So then I have to go back and sit down. This is when I start drinking the shit. Again. And finally, as I'm sitting there, Dale T comes waddling in with his little bow legs. I got my juice. I want to look for your butter now. So he goes and looks for the butter. As he does, I get up. And now I'm going to start making rounds around the freezer section. Now, I found this really, 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 really good Hershey chocolate syrup. I am not a fan of dark chocolate in any way, shape, matter, or form. I don't like it. But this dark Hershey chocolate, really good quality shit. Because if you sprinkle it on vanilla ice cream, it actually starts to thicken and harden. And, like, if you've ever had that vanilla swirl, you get the vanilla with, like, the chocolate swirl, that's exactly what it is. It's that thick consistency, and it's really good. Well, I didn't see any. But I wanted some chocolate syrup anyway, so I was like, oh, fuck it, I'll just get it. As I go down, they've moved stuff around. Because they used to have the ice cream on the other side. And the aisle that I'm currently on, they have, like, bags of chicken, bags of, you know, whatever, the Hot Pockets, things like that, the freezer stuff. And I'm looking at the ice cream, and I'm like, you know what, fuck it, I'm going to get some ice cream. And they got tubs of ice cream, they're like $6. I'm like, you know what, fuck it, I'm going to pick up two chocolates. I don't give a fuck, I'm 400 pounds, I'm going to die anyway, I'm going to die alone, so what the fuck. And as I go down even further, I see these freaking ice cream sandwiches that were like $2 for like 12 of them. I picked up 3 boxes. I didn't care. It was like, what, 2, 4, 6, maybe 7, close to $8 for like 36 of them. I'm like, shit, dude, you can't beat that. And then I go down even further and I see this huge bag of blueberries for like $10 or frozen. And I'm like, fuck that. I picked that shit right up. I figure I'm paying $10. Or $5 for a little dinky container of fresh ones. They got, oh my God. And right next to it, they had strawberries. And I'm like, fuck yeah. So now I've got $20 worth of frozen blueberries and frozen strawberries. And I have actual strawberries, like actual, like little container of them for $5. And an actual literal container of blueberries, sitting right next to him. And I'm thinking, you know what, I'll put the blueberries back because they are a little pricey. And then I ended up burying them, and I'm like, eh, fuck it, I'll just buy them. So I spent like $5. Now again, I got fresh and then I got frozen. They're two different things, but I paid a lot of money for those fresh ones. And you know, I don't even know if they're really all that fresh. So anyways, I make the round, I go back to the other side. Of course, the minute I come around the corner, some old lady's got to rush me, you know, rush right in front of me, and then run 2 feet and then just stop dead. I'm like, you stupid old whore. I mean, if it was still like road rage, I would have rammed her ass from my car. I didn't say anything. I'm like, whatever. Whatever, darling. Now she's over there. She's actually looking at like the Hot Pockets and the other stuff. And I'm like, I don't want Hot Pockets, so I don't care. So I went around her. And as I did, I found these. I don't even know. I hope to God they're good. Because for the price that I paid, they're like less than $8. It was $7-something. This huge thing of chicken tenders. Like chicken nuggets. This bag is huge. Like, I could take this thing and make a pillow out of it. It's how big this fucking bag was. Because usually you get those bags and they're half empty. It's mostly 99% air. This thing was almost full to the brim. Like, oh my God. The amount that you're getting in here, and I hope that God they're good. Especially, oh God, because yeah, they could be horrible. I never thought of that. They could be horrible. Oh shit! Because sometimes you get them and they're like all spongy, and they're gray, and they're made of like rib meat. Ugh, I don't like the rib ones. I want the ones made with real fucking chicken breast, the white meat. So hopefully they're good, because the price actually wasn't that bad. They were under $8, and you get like a shitload of them. Like, I could probably get 10 meals out of these things. Usually, I don't get a lot of meals out of stuff, because I'm just a glutton for, you know, food. So, but like these, I could ration these fuckers off for a month. So anyways, I'm basically wrapping up my existence in this store. And as I come around the other corner to head back to my chair, I see Dale T's holding my butter. He's got two little things of butter. And hey, I need a burger. I'm like, okay, Dale T, put him in the cart. You know, okay. And then as I'm coming back up through, I look, and for $1.69, $1.68, something like that, there's these huge things of Snapple. And I'm like, well, fuck, man, I'm going to buy 4 or 5 of these fuckers. I mean, at the price, shit, that was a good price. And we're talking like one of those huge, huge, huge containers. It wasn't, like, you buy a regular Snapple, it's at least $1, $1.29. So you get one of these huge, like, I don't even know what it was, how many ounces it was. That's just got to be at least 60 to 100 ounces. I mean, these things were big. And I'm like, for that price, you can't beat it. So I picked up the lemon Snapple. I picked up the peach Snapple. And it was some other Snapple. I don't even know what the fuck it was. Actually, I don't know what it was, whatever. So, yeah, that's kind of cool. Put that shit on ice, it'll be really good. Oh, another thing I found, I'm going to have to do like a taste test thing. I may even do a video of it, because I saw this, I don't remember if it was on YouTube or if it was on Facebook, but I saw a commercial. And it was for Canada Dry. They have a new Canada Dry ginger ale lemonade. And I was like, I don't know how I feel about that. But when I was in the dollar store, I saw it. And I was like, well, shit, we got to try this. And for like $1.32, I picked it up. $1.38, something like that, somewhere in there. I was like, well, shit, let's pick that up and try that some bitch. So that might actually be halfway decent. Who knows? Anyways. Yeah, it's been a busy fucking day, dude. I'm physically exhausted. I gotta bring in my groceries yet. And, like, I don't know why. I'm sorry, people need, this is a pet peeve that I have, because it was a pet peeve my mother had. And it was, people do not know how to bag groceries properly. Because my mother would constantly rail against, oh, I was in retail for 16, 18, 20 years, depending on how long it was when she actually did it. She was railing about it for many years, so. I mean, she was in it for like 20 years. So, like, when the 16 mark came up, like, oh, I was 16 years, oh, I was 18 years, you know. She was railing on it for years, like I said. About how she was in wholesale retail and blah, blah, blah. And how people need to learn how to do stuff. People need to learn how to count money. Like, little stickler things. Like, if you got a bunch of money, the faces all need to be facing the right way. And that's just something that's just, like, I do now. It's not really unconsciously, but it's like when I've got money, it's like I have to turn it so all the heads are facing the right way. Just because I know it would irritate her, and it's just something I like to do myself, because it kind of irritates me. So it's really a weird little thing. But people need to learn how to fucking bag groceries. Jeez. Oh, like if you got ice cream, you need to double bag that shit. Those frozen vegetables, or the frozen fruit, you need to double bag that shit. So, I get half the stuff into the cart. All the Snapple bottles, they try to fit two in each bag. They tip over and fall out of the bag, rip the bags all the hell, and it's like, what the fuck? Anyways, that was my day shopping. I still don't know what's going on with the bank. I got like almost $180 in limbo. I don't know, man. I got at least two things coming out that I don't have money for in my account yet. So I don't know. This was not my fault. So hopefully, God willing, the whole thing just kind of fixes itself, alleviates its own problem, because it created the problem, not me. This is definitely something that I did not do. Anyways. I guess that's all I got. Is there anything else I want to talk? Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. I'm tired. I'm really tired. I'm sorry this clip was kind of like all over the place and just kind of monotone, and it was just, oh, I'm not feeling it. I mean, that's how freaking tired I am. It's just, I feel like shit. My back hurts. My leg is all fucked up. Oh my God. I may have to start paying somebody to go to the store for me. Going to like Walmart and shit. I may have to pay Cousin Cindy to do it. Because fucking A, dude. I can't do it. Refuse to do it. It's not even that. Believe me, I wish I had a choice. It's just physically, it's like your back is like, yeah, no motherfucker, you ain't going anywhere. You want to go get some ice cream? Fuck you, fat ass. You ain't getting shit. When you're 400 pounds and you can't get ice cream, you know you're in trouble. Okay. Yeah. It ain't like I was, you know, fighting off, you know, back pain to try to get to the cucumbers and the salad dressing, you know. It wasn't like I was trying to eat healthy. I mean, when you can't physically get your fat ass to the donuts and the cookies and shit, you know you're in trouble. Okay. Anyways, I'm done. I gotta rest. That's all today's gonna be, and most of tomorrow is just I gotta rest. No, actually, you realize that I just finished drinking that entire large root beer. I bought a root beer at Burger King. I drank the entire thing, and I haven't had to pee yet. So all that drink that I had before I went to the store, the shit that I was sipping in the store, the entire root beer that I had, I haven't peed yet. And I don't even feel like I have to pee. Oh, God, that's not good. That's not good. I mean, I'm definitely going to have to pee at some point, but, like, I can feel I'm going to, like, I probably have to pee in, like, five, 6 minutes. Like, if I got up right now, I'd probably go pee. So it's not like I can't pee, but it's just, that's how dehydrated I am, because it's like, you know, like I said, my mouth is all pustered and like stingy and chappy, and it's like, are you fucking kidding me? And like, it, right around the edge is like stinging and shit. Oh, whatever, dude. Whatever. I basically need to pay somebody to take care of me. I should be in like one of those adult homes or something. Get one of those adult homes that take dogs. You know, I need to pay people to, like take care of me and shit. But I don't have money to pay people. You know? I used to have somebody come in once or twice a month to, like, check on my shit, you know? Oh, God. I don't know. I'm physically tired. I gotta go bring my groceries in because it's warm out and I don't want my stuff sitting out there. I don't think there's anything that could spoil. I don't have any lunch meat or anything. I got some lettuce. I bought some, like, romaine lettuce. I don't know why the fuck I did. It was sitting there. And I'm like, you know, because they had those weird, not spinach, but it was some sort of, like, lettuce-y, flowery, not flower, but more, like, stalk. Not stalk, no. Like, you know how there's, like, the head of lettuce and there's, like, that romaine stuff? This was more like sprouts or some shit. And I'm like, you know what? Fuck it. Let's try to eat healthier. So I got a bunch of cookies and ice cream. And I got a bunch of, like, cucumbers and salad stuff. So, yeah, you know what? Fuck it. I try, you know? I honestly did try. And that's all I got to say on it. I at least try it, you know? Anyways, you know, I'm done. I don't want to talk to you anymore. Fuck you.